One more quick thing I wanted to talk about with the Bible. I kind of already mentioned it, but just a line I wrote down in my notes was like, yeah, I guess I already talked about it. Jesus just says, like, what's lawful to do on the Sabbath, good or evil? Yeah, I already talked about it. Just like, keep it simple. Don't make too many rules. I would have liked more stuff like that in the Gospels. But the first three are like, just repeat the same stories. I can feel, I mean, I feel uncomfortable around everybody, but I wrote down a note about how I feel uncomfortable around my family, like my cousins and my uncles and stuff. I was just thinking about it because one of my cousins from Ohio is coming, and we're gonna see them tomorrow. What? I don't think that's supposed to happen. I thought a big reason why I was uncomfortable around them was because I lived at home and I was embarrassed. Hey. But
just trying to keep warm. How's it looking up
there? That's not the reason anymore because I don't live at home, so. It's just, it's all in my head. Anxiety and worrying about stuff. What are you gonna do? What? He jumped right on top of me. I'm also worried about my brother had a son. He's about a year and a half old, I think. I'm just worried that I'll be like weird around him. I want to be like a good uncle. And I feel like, so I have to go out here and then come back. I feel like uncles are supposed to be like goofy and fun, and I'm worried I'll just be nervous around them and then he'll think I'm weird. I don't know. Trying to think of stuff maybe my uncles did that I liked. I mean, when I was a kid, all you had to do was like get me a video game and I would be happy. That's all I cared about, really. I remember my uncle. I guess I should. I mean, I could always buy him stuff. But, like, maybe buying him a video game would be like my uncle buying me a football or something. So I'd have to know what he likes. My brother's kind of like me. He likes nerdy stuff like video games and Star Wars or whatever. So you'd think like his kid would be like that too, but maybe you never know. I don't know. He always texts me about like a video game thing. Or we talk about sports like the Mets are, shoot, 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 shoot. And I used to think like maybe he just does that because he wants to talk to me and he wants to. He probably knows like that I don't talk to people that much. And he wants to talk to me about stuff. But I think he really just likes that stuff and he doesn't have anybody to talk about it with because he lives in California. And his friends are all like 35 or 40 years old, so they don't play video games that much, or, and they don't like the Mets, and that's stuff that he likes to talk about. So I'm really the only one he can talk about it with. Who can see me? Who can see me?
Everything's cool, man, huh?
I think you turn this off. Still terrible. Okay, is this a cutscene? What was I talking about? Being a good uncle. I did like playing like I remember playing like we went to the beach with my uncle and my cousins and stuff.
All right, check it out.
And we would play wiffle ball, and I really liked doing that for some reason.
We're good. Sam, let's go.
All right, kid, come on. There you go. Come on.
Oh, shit.
Hurry, hurry.
Stay locked.
Ready?
Gotcha.
Okay, we gotta get him up.
I'm sorry. We're leaving.
What? This is bullshit.
Hey, now!
What the fuck, Henry? We stick together.
For some reason, I remember my uncle getting the Pokemon cards and really liking that. I don't know why I remember that, but I was like 6 or something. I think I was like 10 and my uncle died. He had cancer. And I remember being sad. Ah. So he must have done a good job being an uncle if I was sad about it. It sounds insane to say this, but that's like a goal. Like if I die, I want my nephew to be sad. Let's just hit him with a lead pipe.
Too damn close. I'm gonna go to your head. Gotta go to theirs.
The reason I'm worried, I guess, is because one of my cousins has two kids, and they're like 6. They're like 3 and 6 or something. And I don't do a good job with them. Like when I'm around them, I'm just weird and I don't talk to them and stuff. I'm worried the same thing will happen with my nephew. Especially because I'll only see them like once or twice a year because they live so far away. So there's obviously there's two sides of my family, and I feel more comfortable around the one side that I saw like more often. So I'm afraid my nephew won't comfortable. Like he'll feel the way that I felt around the side of the family that I wasn't comfortable around. And I don't know what to do to avoid that.
How many bullets do you have left?
They're gonna kill us.
What other choice do we have?
We jump.
No, it's too high and you can't swim. I'll boost you up, you run past him.
You keep me afloat!
Ellie!
No time to argue!
Ellie!
Henry! He's awake!
Hey, you. We're alive.
Okay. See? What'd I tell you, huh? He's good. Everything's fine.
You know, Sam's the one who spotted you. You guys are taking quite a bit of water.
What's wrong? Henry!
Get back,
hey,
Sean!
Hey, hey, hey!
He's pissed, but he's not gonna do anything.
You sure about that?
Stop!
Joel?
He left us to die out there.
No. You had a good chance of making it, and you did. Coming back for you, putting him at risk. Stay back. If it was the other way around, would you have come back for us? I saved you.
He saved me too. We would have drowned.
It's fine, us. I'm okay. You know, for what it's worth, I'm really glad we spotted you. Now, that radio tower, it's on the other side of this cliff. Okay? Place is gonna be full of supplies. You're gonna be really happy you didn't kill me.
Hey, we're gonna search this area. See what we come up with.
That was intense. You cool?
Yeah. Let's go find that radio tower.
Another one down.